Today we will start our problem with a square. Then, from its upper left corner, we will pull the line to the right side of the square, and let's say that this line has the length of 10. Now, from the intersection point of this line and the right side of the square, we will pull another line that is perpendicular to our previously constructed line, and let's say that this line has the length of 5. The question is, can we somehow calculate the area of this red square? Well, if you want to answer this question for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So first we will label the sides of the square as S. Then let's notice two right triangles. The first one is the green right triangle located at the upper part of our square, and the next one is a blue right triangle located at the bottom right side of our square. Next, let's label the acute angle of our green triangle as alpha. Since the green triangle is the right triangle, this means that the other acute angle must be equal to 90 degrees minus alpha. But if we take a look at the acute angle of the blue triangle, you can see that it forms 180 degrees with the angles 90 degree minus alpha and the 90 degree angle in the middle. This of course means that this acute angle must also have the value of alpha. So, since both triangles have two congruent angles, this means that their third angle must also be congruent. So, the blue triangle and green triangle are in fact similar triangles. Alright, so now let's label the remaining leg of our green triangle as X. And since we know that the side of the square is equal to S, you can clearly see that the remaining segment of the right side of the square must be equal to the difference between the side of the square and X. Alright, so now let's isolate both of our triangles, and since we know that they are similar triangles, we will use the rule of similarity. We can say that the relation between their hypotenuse must be equal to the relation between their corresponding legs. So, if we cross-multiply this, we will get the following. Now, we will expand the right side of the equation, and after simplification, we will get that 10x is equal to 5s. Now, we can simplify by dividing both sides with 5, and we will finally get that x must be equal to the half of the side of the square. Great, so now let's set our attention to the green right triangle, and let's substitute the value of x for s over 2. Now we will use the Pythagorean theorem on this triangle. We can say that the leg s over 2 squared plus the leg s squared must be equal to the hypotenuse 10 squared. Then, we will put everything to the square, and we can lose the fraction by multiplying both sides with 4. Then, we will get the following, and finally, we will get that 5s squared is equal to 400, which means that s squared is equal to 80. But, remember, we want to find the area of the red square, and since the side of this square is equal to s, this means that the area of the red square is equal to s squared. But we already found the value of s squared, so that means that the area of our red square must be equal to 80 squared units, and this is our solution. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this problem, and if you did, leave a like and consider subscribing to the channel for more content like this in the future. And if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section below. I always check your solutions. And of course, until next time, as always, see you guys and take care.